We just had a big direct, but that does not stop the weekly new Switch games from coming. There are more announcements beyond the direct, and one is so freaking yummy. But before we get to those, Gabe, we did a little giveaway last week, and we gotta pick a winner.
Yep, Zach, you have the winner right in front of you. We're going to keep doing these. Hopefully you guys enjoy the giveaways. We have a lot of cool stuff to give to you guys today. More than one thing. Quick little tease for them, Zach. I like teasing them.
Yes, you are such a tease, but no more teasing. Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition from last week goes to the Momo channel. Boom, baby. You get yourself a big, beautiful code for Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition. Go message us on Twitter, please. It's at the Switch Force, and we'll get that right over to you. This week, Gabe, this week we've got a pretty sweet prize, and we've heard Nintendo saying, hey, they want to add oomph to the online service. They want people to buy those 12-month subscriptions. Well, while they still figure that out, why don't we give you a 12-month subscription? So all you got to do is like the video and leave a comment letting us know what Switch game you want to play online, and you can be entered to win a 12-month online code.
Yes, we will give away the code during next week's episode, just like we did today. So this is where you come to find out for everyone that always asks. And now that we give that away, Zach, I think there's some games we have to talk about.
Hold on, Gabe. Maybe people don't want to like the video. Oh. Maybe they don't like the video. And that's okay, because we're also giving away a copy or code for a 12-month subscription over on our Twitter page. You can enter in both. That's fine. All you got to go do is retweet the video tweet about this new Switch Games video. Twitter.com/TheSwitchForce. There's a link in the description. Another 12-month subscription will be given away there. Two prizes this week, baby. It was a big week. And so we had to go big. All you got to go do is follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/TheSwitchForce, and retweet this video's tweet, the tweet about this video. And we'll be back next week with those winners. But yes, Gabe, a lot of games during the Direct.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of them.
A lot.
Somehow there's still more.
Yes.
Somehow there's still six more. We got six games for you, and they're all new. And one of them is even kind of like a group announcement of like six of its own games. So you could think of it as like 10 plus. But Hollow Knight Silksong. Gabe, Team Cherry teased that they were going to reveal some new information on Hollow Knight DLC. They lied.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be DLC. I don't know who's trickier, you or them. Full-fledged sequel. It adds a whole bunch of color and all types of new gameplay elements, new enemies, new bosses, new areas. I'm excited for this one. I've played some Hollow Knight. Now I know that I better hurry up and get to it so I can get my Silksong on as well.
Yes, and you get to play as a hornet, which is freaking awesome. I feel like if the first game starred you, this game stars me. A little taller, a little thinner, probably crazier, and it looks really freaking awesome. A brand new Bold Kingdom, all sorts of new bosses. No date, but it's coming to Switch, and that is awesome. Very excited for this one. Team Cherry was very pumped, and they talked about how like they'd held this under wraps for so long that it wasn't DLC, but that it was going to be a brand new game. And like, that genuinely would have been one of like the big surprises of the Direct. I'm surprised it didn't make it in, honestly.
Yeah, they probably wanted to keep it to themselves. This is Team Cherry's second game. They're like so new. Hollow Knight is so beloved and it's sold so well all over the place. But to think that this is only the second game they're making, that's weird.
And Gabe, console exclusive at launch. May come to another platform in the future. They didn't rule that out, but you got Windows, Mac, Linux, and Nintendo Switch. Great get. Love it. All right, let's move on to Colt Canyon, Gabe. Hey, your favorite genre. We got to get one of these in there every week. It is a pixel art shooter with roguelike elements, and it's coming in Q3. It actually looks pretty cool. It says, loot, shoot, dodge, reload. Take your revolver and rescue your kidnapped partner in this atmospheric and punchy roguelike game.
A range of characters and weapons at play and unlock, dynamic and immersive environments and enemies, AI-controlled companions, local co-op, upgrades, randomized. Ugh.
Permadeath. Replayability.
There's a lot of these games on Switch.
You need to fall in love with this genre.
Do I?
It's Valentine's Day. Share some love with this genre, please.
No, this genre is definitely not my Valentine.
By the end of sometime, we're gonna figure this out for you. We're gonna figure it out. It reminds me honestly of like a pixelized version. I'm blanking on what it's called, but there is a PlayStation 4 like PSN game where you're like cowboys and it's like
Hard West
2-on-2. Yeah. No, it's like a multiplayer one.
Oh.
Someone out there knows what it is, but this looks like a demake of that. Anyways, I'm paying attention to it. It is coming in Q3, and I think it looks very cool. Okay. You know what's even cooler, though, than Cold Canyon?
I don't know.
Ugly Dolls, an Imperfect Adventure. I am so mystified why this didn't make it into the Direct. Disney Tsum Tsum is in the Direct.
Wait, hold on. Am I missing something? Is Ugly Dolls a thing?
Oh, yeah. These are a thing. You've never seen these guys?
Nah.
I would say probably about 15 years ago. I don't know. Maybe it's a little long. 10 to 15 years ago, these guys were like a very popular, like, get them at Barnes & Noble. Like an Ugly Doll. Like, whoa, it's a weird plushie that's not cute, but on purpose. And it's kind of charming in that way. So they're getting a brand new adventure, an Imperfect Adventure. Apparently there's a film coming on May 3rd, so the game is coming April 26th to get you hyped for the movie. They're doing things right. Like, Lego Movie game isn't out yet for the new Lego Movie. Ugly Dolls in Perfect Adventure, it's coming out before. Bring fun to Uglyville as the Ugly Dolls rid their town of Perfection's robots. You can play together with local multiplayer. Procedurally generated elements?
Oh, I'm out.
Gosh, collect, use, and craft items to overcome enemies? Gabe... sometimes I like to believe that the real Direct occurs outside of the Direct, but you can pick Ugly Dolls up in April. All right, Modern Combat Blackout. Gabe, this is a Gameloft game, which is a bit interesting coming to the platform.
Hmm.
It's actually out now. It was recently announced. It's $20, and it's out. This is a mobile FPS. How do you feel about a $20 mobile FPS?
Not good. Not good. I don't want Modern Combat on Switch. They are mobile games. I've played them on phones before. Yeah, nah. It does have an intense solo campaign. You can play the challenging Spec Ops missions for a real-life adrenaline rush, Zach. Fast-paced story missions with various challenges will take players from Tokyo to Venice.
Huh. It's based on Modern Combat 5, which is a free download with in-app purchases on your phone. It's got a campaign, multiplayer, hard pass.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Hard pass for me. All right, Gabe. Fairy Tales. Tell me about them.
Zach. First of all, before I tell you about them, what is your favorite fairy tale?
It's the one about the weird little monster that grabbed all the toys and he grew so many arms. What's that one called?
I don't know, but the answer is not Cinderella, and we're getting a mature-themed Cinderella game.
It's called Cinders, and it has 120 decision points, 300 different choices, multiple endings. This one's also out today, a very short turnaround. That's kind of a thing. It is a storied visual novel, and it is a very intense version of Cinderella. Everyone looks miserable in the trailer. Cinderella had a little more charm when it was a Disney film, but here things are rough, Gabe. The world has gone cold. They haven't got a Direct in at least 16 years over in the world of Cinder, so I understand their plight.
There's so many different choices, like 300. That's a lot. Multiple endings, 120 decisions, but that's a lot, man.
I was really thinking, like, when this started off, like, okay, I genuinely think Cold Canyon looks cool. Hollow Knight Silksong, obviously, that is a jam. After that, I feel like maybe there's a reason that the Direct happened and these guys didn't get as much of the limelight. But hey, if you're into Cinderella and fairy tales, you're a big Disney fan and can't wait for Tsum Tsum Festival, maybe you grab Cinders. It's out. Last but not least, this is a pretty big announcement if you're an old school fan. Skybound and Beamdog are bringing 6 D&D games to the Switch this year. So Skybound, if you don't know who they are, they took over for The Walking Dead, and they're teaming up with this Beamdog company to bring Baldur's Gate, Baldur's Gate 2, Baldur's Gate Siege of Dragonspear, Icewind Dale, Planescape Torment, and Neverwinter Nights all to the Switch, and it says they'll be sold physically and digitally.
Individually?
Digitally.
No, I know. Zach, I know.
Oh. I was like, come again?
When they say physically... Are they a pack? Is it like individual games? Like, I know.
It says that more details will be revealed in the coming months about the physical release. I would guess it's got to be a pack, right? These games are pretty old, pretty revered. Do you have any nostalgia or memory of these titles?
Well, I know people love Baldur's Gate. I've never played it. I've never been into D&D. Like, it's not my thing.
Not for you.
I've kind of wanted it to be my thing, honestly. Like, I want to try D&D.
Hey,
but
here you go.
Yeah, I mean...
Icewind Dale, Planescape Torment, Baldur's Gate, very, very, very popular. I don't have experience with any of these. I liked Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance on GameCube. If that brings you back for any Nintendo fans, that was a really fun time. Me and my best friend Jono at the time would play a lot of Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance on my beautiful purple GameCube. But yeah, they're bringing six old games back, and all this year, I'm hoping that it's a nice combo pack that has a pretty good price, because that would be cool. I don't know that these are worthy of like the Final Fantasy treatment, where everything gets its own individual slot. Also, please don't follow the Final Fantasy blueprint and give us Baldur's Gate 2, then Planescape, then Baldur's Gate 1.
Release them out of order, man. Don't worry about it.
Oh my goodness gracious. That still baffles my mind.
Yeah.
I mean, you have a numerical order for a reason, guys. I guess it doesn't matter with Final Fantasy, but
no, it really it's just doesn't so funny matter to see that be like, Fantasy.
9, 12, 7, no 8. What's going on? We love it. But yeah, that's the list for the week.
Wait, seriously, why did Squall get shafted? Where is Final Fantasy VIII?
I have no idea. He's taken up, you know, I don't know. Maybe he does not want to be played.
I thought the gun blades were so cool back in the day. I wanted one. I always used to pretend a stick in the backyard was a gun blade, and I used to like recreate my own Final Fantasy stories. Fun fact.
How much fun did you have with the card game in VIII?
Oh, yeah, that was a really good little minigame.
It's like an intense minigame there. All right, those are our games. It started off strong, got a little weaker, but hey, it's a direct week, so we'll give these announcements a pass. Remember to like the video and leave a comment letting us know what game you want to play with Nintendo Switch Online and why in the comments down below. We'll be giving away a 12-month subscription here. And hey, if you want to be different or if you just want double the chances, go follow us on Twitter and retweet the video. Tweet twitter.com/theSwitchForce. My pick of the week game, obviously Hollow Knight Silksong.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to pick anything else. Hollow Knight is something I like really, really want to love. I haven't just had the time to get into it, but I know I will before Silksong comes on. So I'm going to piggyback off you and go with that. None of these other games really draw my attention too much.
I think Cold Canyon's gonna be cool, and I'm gonna get you an ugly doll. In the meantime, everybody, though, have a fantastic week. Thanks so much for watching. We'll be back next week with more announcements, new winner, new giveaway. So stay tuned for that. Until then, though, have a fantastic day. Make sure to subscribe to stay up to date on the latest and greatest from the Switch and its games and life updates from me and Gabe, like the fact that Gabe used to pretend a stick was a gunblade. We got more of those coming your way. Until then, though, for myself and Gabe, fantastic day. Thanks so much. Switch Force, out.